What's up, you guys? It's Graham here. So let's face it, I've spent a lot of my time trying to find the most creative ways I can to save money. In the past, I've done online surveys, I've done focus groups, I've signed up for bank accounts to get the bonus, and I still open a few credit cards a year to get the free travel points. But sometimes the best ways to make extra money are right in front of us in the common items that we use every single day. Now sure, sometimes these items might cost you a little bit more money up front, but make no mistake, these 10 things will end up paying for themselves rather quickly and then even make you money when you consider just how much money you're going to be saving long term. Not to mention, many of these could end up giving you a way better return than you ever could by investing in stocks or in real estate or in Tesla stock or by smashing the like button for the YouTube algorithm. So needless to say, the ROI on these could add up very quickly. So let me not delay this any longer. I'm way too excited to talk about this. So with that said, let's get into the video. Now first, we're going to be talking about something that doesn't cost a lot of money, but I believe over everything, this will make the biggest difference in terms of how much money you make and to change your entire outlook on life, and that would be the book Think and Grow Rich by Napoleon Hill. Seriously, there are very few things I would ever recommend this strongly, but this is one of them. When it comes to making money, building wealth, and progressing in your career, I really believe a big part of that is mental. And this book really gives you the exact strategies and blueprint to think like someone who makes millions of dollars and achieves whatever they set out to do. I first read this book as a teenager, and it changed my entire outlook on life, and then since then, I read this book about every year or so, just to remind myself of the power of positive thinking. So no joke, just going through this book and internalizing its teachings could easily end up making you a significant amount of money over the course of your lifetime. But wait, there's more. I have the perfect solution, and that would be thanks to our video sponsor today, Audible. That's right, it's that time of year again where you make and set New Year's goals and resolutions, and they're very easy to make, but even harder to keep. Audible believes that listening can help motivate, inspire, inform, and help keep you successful in 2020 and beyond. Their content includes an unmatched selection of audiobooks, original audio shows, news, and comedy, including this book I just mentioned, Think and Grow Rich. Even for me, it's hard sometimes to find the time to actually sit down and read, but with the amount of time I spend in the car, listening to an audiobook is really the perfect solution. So whether it's becoming physically fit, financially fit, or learning to become a better person or leader, it's all on Audible. You can listen anywhere, anytime, on any device, including mobile, Alexa, Bluetooth, and more. And to help motivate you, Audible is issuing a challenge to its current and new members. Finish 3 books by March 3rd, and they will be giving you a $20 Amazon credit. It's that simple. Just finish 3 books by the date 3/3, and you'll get $20. How easy is that? Plus, there's nothing to enter. Audible will automatically keep track of your progress for you. And with Audible, you'll also enjoy easy audiobook exchanges and your own audiobook library that you could keep forever, even if you cancel. So go to audible.com/GrahamStephan or text GrahamStephan to 500-500 to get an exclusive 30-day free trial, 1 free audiobook of your choice, and 2 Audible originals absolutely free. So with that said, let's go on to the next thing that will end up paying for itself and making you money. The second, we're going to be talking about something that I know you're all too familiar with, but it's certainly an epidemic that's plaguing our society, and that would be coffee. And that means the second purchase that will end up paying for itself really quickly is a coffee maker. See, the sad reality is that according to the investment app Acorns, 1/3 of Americans spend more money on coffee than they do on retirement. Not to mention, people between the ages of 25 and 34 spend an average of over $2,000 a year on this deliciously amazing drink. But we really have to call it for what it is. A waste of money. Because instead, you could spend $25 on a coffee maker and then another $10 on coffee and filters. And with that, you can make your own coffee at home for a fraction of the price. So for someone who goes and pays $3 on a cup of Starbucks every single morning, spending $35 on coffee, making it at home, will pay for itself in less than 2 weeks, and then everything else after that is profit. Seriously, doing this could lead to a savings of almost $2,000 a year for the average coffee drinker just by doing this yourself. I've been making coffee at home for years now, and I have to say, nothing tastes better than coffee that only costs you 20 cents a cup to make and allows you to invest the entire difference into something else that will end up making you more money. The third, since we all need to eat, food is obviously a necessity. And one of the best ways to cut back and buy something that will end up paying for itself very quickly is with a crock pot. For less than $40, and for anyone who can't cook that well, like me, a crock pot is a blessing. All you need to do is throw in some meat and vegetables and then forget about it until later. Then after afterwards, you're gonna get a really delicious home-cooked meal for a fraction of the price of going out and eating at a restaurant. Even if doing this just ends up saving you $5 per meal instead of grabbing food on the way home. Your total cost for the crock pot plus ingredients should end up paying for itself within 2 weeks, and then anything else after that is profit. If you looked at that in terms of an investment, that would equate to a 2,600% return just by saving $5 a day, 5 times per week over the course of a year. See, sometimes the best way to make money is by cutting back on what you already spend and then investing the difference. And coming home to a gorgeous looking crock pot is absolutely a really good way to do that. Now, fourth, speaking of ways to cut back and save money, this is something I switched to a few years ago and it made a tremendous difference, and that was by buying rechargeable batteries. Seriously, just look around your place and notice all of the things that use batteries. I'm talking remotes, audio devices, those fake candles you buy for decorations. A lot of things still take batteries these days. And I didn't realize how expensive batteries were lately. Like seriously, this package of AA batteries will run you about $16 at the store. But for a little bit more, you can get a whole bunch of rechargeable batteries and never have to replace them ever again. Before doing this, I found myself going through 40 packs of AA batteries every few weeks with all the filming that I do. So instead, I switched over to the rechargeable ones, and I have not bought new batteries in years. My cost went from about $5 a week in batteries all the way down to maybe a few cents in electricity charges during off-peak electrical hours. So definitely consider doing this, and spending $20 up front could easily save you 5 times that over the next few years if you end up using batteries as often as I do. The same also applies with number 5 on this list, and that would be by buying a reusable water bottle. First of all, the cost of bottled water is getting outrageous. Like, have you seen those little $3 to $5 Fiji waters that they sell at the grocery store checkout line? Or have you ever been out somewhere and you don't want to drink from the water fountain and the only thing available is overpriced bottled water from the local vendors? Well, really, the way around that is just with a reusable water bottle. If your refrigerator has a water filter in it, then go ahead, fill it up, and carry on with your entire day without ever needing to buy water. Or combine that with a $15 Brita water filter and you're set for a very long time. Not to mention, this $15 hydro flask can carry whatever you want, including iced coffee. So going and buying this once should ideally pay for itself rather quickly, especially if you're the type to go and buy bottled water or go and buy a drink when you're out. Plus, think of all the plastic that you're going to be saving and how that's going to be helping the environment. Not to mention, one more life hack when it comes to this is that if you're ever out somewhere and you don't want to pay for water, most restaurants will end up filling up a free cup of water for you as long as you just ask politely. Next, number 6 is something that most of us need to use on a daily basis, and it could be costly. But if you get this instead, it could end up paying for itself over the next few years, and that would be by buying a reliable used car. For anyone who has a daily commute or finds themselves ordering Ubers to get around, a used reliable car can be a phenomenal purchase. I'd also recommend doing this instead of going and leasing an expensive car or buying a new car every few years that does nothing but depreciate. Now, in terms of making and saving money, going with a vehicle that's already seen the majority of its depreciation could be a great way to cut back on your expenses and drive a car without losing much value. Even if you think this is not something that will make you money, it certainly will if you can put in the time and effort to do it correctly. Now, I mentioned this before in one of my previous videos, but this is by doing what's called car hacking. And I know it sounds super sketchy. It sounds like I'm telling you to go and steal a car or learn how to hotwire whatever car is on your street, and then it's yours. You drive it for free. Don't do that. This term of car hacking is when you could buy a car under market value that's already seen the majority of its depreciation, to the point where you could drive it around for a few years and it'll still be worth about what you paid for it. So in terms of paying for transportation, doing this could potentially save you tens of thousands of dollars that would otherwise be lost to depreciation. And all of those savings could just be used towards other things that will end up making you way more money. And that brings us to number 7. When you're out there driving your reliable used car, might be a good idea to install a dash cam. This is a camera that's installed to the front of your car that continuously records footage in the event anything happens. Now, chances are, hopefully, you're never gonna have to use it. But the $50 to $100 you spend on this is almost like an insurance if anything were to happen, and you need proof to back up your claims to an insurance company. Like, say someone pulls in front of you and then blames you and says you're at fault. Or if an insurance company blames you and says that you need to pay a higher insurance premium because of that. Well, this is where the dash cam would pay for itself. You could show proof of footage to back up your claims and potentially get you out of paying an insanely high insurance premium. titanium. I have one of these already built into my Tesla, and even though I've never needed to use it, knock on wood, it certainly serves as peace of mind just in the event anything were to happen. And even if this ends up saving you money on one accident throughout your entire life, it could very well end up paying for itself many, many times over. So then you might be asking yourself, well, what do I do with all of this money that I just saved by making coffee at home, eating from a crock pot, buying rechargeable batteries, getting a reusable water bottle, driving a used car, getting a dash cam? What's next? Well, that's a good question. In terms of buying things that will end up making you money, one of the best things that you can end up buying into is the stock market. This is where you can buy into a small ownership portion of a particular company or group of companies, and as their value goes up, so does your profit. Then, in addition to that, many stocks pay what's called dividends. This is where they pay you every quarter just for owning their stock, depending on the profits of the company. So, needless to say, if you want to buy something that's going to end up making you money, the stock market is the way to go. And also, if you're anything like me and just want to take as passive and easy of an approach as possible, you could also buy into what's known as an index fund. This is basically just a big basket of stocks that you could buy into, and then you own a small percentage of everything. That way, if one of those stocks doesn't end up doing that well, not to worry, you have hundreds of others to fall back on. For me, when it comes to this, I prefer VT Sachs, which covers the top 500 publicly traded companies in the United States. Long term, this averages about a 7% return when adjusted for inflation. So if you want your money to make you money, then this would be the way to do it. I also highly recommend, as the ninth thing that you could buy to make you money, real estate. The way I see it is that we all need a place to live, and if you're strategic about it, you can find a way for this to pay for itself. And one of the ways I do this is by house hacking. This is where you buy a multifamily building with 2 to 4 units, and you move in one of the units and then rent out the others to cover your cost of living. If done correctly, you should be able to break even on the cost of the property without ever coming out of pocket, thereby living for free. Then where the profit comes in is that after a few years of doing this, you can move out and into another property where you do the exact same thing, except now you have a vacant unit that you could rent out and then do the exact same thing in the next one. You could hypothetically just go and do this every few years, and then over the course of a decade, you will have built up a pretty extensive rental property portfolio with properties that are hopefully cash flowing. You could even do this with a house as well. If you go and buy a house that's a good enough deal that would cash flow as a rental whenever you move out, you can always buy a house, live in it for a few years, and then buy another house to rent out the first one. Then just keep repeating the process while you continue paying down the mortgage and going and collecting rental properties. Within 30 years, many of those properties are going to be paid off, and you will be collecting a sizable amount of rent every single month. Now, obviously, I'm simplifying this process a lot, but if you're interested, I'll link to a few other videos I've done down below in the description that go over all of these concepts in great detail. Then finally, the 10th thing to finish off this list, in terms of buying something that will pay for itself and make you a profit, you can almost never go wrong with education. This could be in the form of buying a book or watching countless hours of YouTube like I do, or going to a network event, or doing anything to improve your skills. All of these have the potential to yield a 100-time return on the money that you spend in terms of your future earning potential. The same also applies with money you spend starting up a business or pursuing something you really believe in. There's really no shortage of ways to invest back into yourself that will make you a lot more money later on down the line. Even going and buying a gym membership could be seen as an investment that will pay for itself. Because the healthier you are, the more energy you'll have, which means the more work you'll do, which means the more money you'll make. It's as simple as that. So find a way to spend some of this money back on yourself, because really at the end of the day, you are your best investment and you have the potential to make way more money than you ever thought was imaginable. So if you have any other suggestions or items that you found that pay for themselves, let me know down below in the comment section. I read almost everything and I am constantly looking at new ways to save money. And I still need to buy a Costco membership, by the way. I've been a few times and they have the best samples when you go for lunch. So that's pretty much another way to get a free meal. But anyway, those are my top 10 things to buy that will end up paying for themselves and making you money. Because really at the end of the day, the money you save is just as good as the money you make, because no matter what, that's money back in your pocket. So by thinking outside the box and finding creative ways to cut back, it'll leave you with so much more money left over to invest, and smash the like button for the YouTube algorithm. So with that said, you guys, thank you so much for watching. I really appreciate it. As always, if you've not already subscribed, feel free to subscribe and hit the notification bell so YouTube notifies you anytime I post a video. Also, feel free to add me on Instagram. I post there pretty much daily, so if you want to be a part part of it there. Feel free to add me there, as on my second channel, The Graham Stephan Show. I post there every day. I'm not posting here. So if you want to see a brand new video from me every single day, make sure to add yourself to that. And lastly, if you guys want 2 free stocks, speaking of things that you could do that will make you money, Webull is going to give you 2 free stocks when you deposit $100 on their platform. And one of those stocks is going to be valued up to $1,400. So if you want a great chance to have 2 free stocks, with one of them having the potential to be worth a lot of money, make sure to do that. It's a pretty good stock trading platform with $0 stock trades. It's like a Robinhood, except slightly more advanced. So if you want to be a part of that, just link down below in the description. Let me know what you get. Thank you so much for watching, and until next time.